Excel 2007 now includes improved print features to help you print your worksheet right the first time. Through the Page Layout and Page Break Preview tools, which you'll find down here in your status bar in the right-hand corner, you can control where your page breaks and how your page displays. We've briefly touched upon these tools previously in this tutorial. Let's take a better look at them now. I have a sample worksheet opened on my display, and notice if I come down here and choose the Page Layout tool, it will cause my page to display showing my headers and my footers, as well as you also have rulers to help you line up items on your screen, and it gives you a more complete view of how your document will look prior to printing. Also note that we have the Page Break Preview tool, and when I select this tool, it will show me where my page breaks on this document. So this is actually a two-page document, this one being page one, and this small column, column E over here, breaks and will fall on page two. Notice you have this dashed line that goes all the way down your page. This indicates that you have a page break at this point. Now, to adjust your page breaks in the Page Break Preview, you can go ahead and position your mouse on the dashed line, and notice I get a double arrow tool, and if I click and drag, I can pull this page break all the way over to the end of column E, forcing my page now to all be on one page. And to see this, if I take this down in magnification, notice that my entire page now is on one page. I'll go ahead and bring my magnification back up to 100%. And then to also show, these two tools are also available on your ribbon. If you come up here to your View tab on your ribbon, select that. Notice that over here in your workbook views, you have Normal View, which we're in Normal View right now, Page Layout View, which again will show you your headers and your footers, your margins, give you rulers to work with, as well as this tool right up here is the Page Break Preview. And again, it will show you how your page looks with page breaks. And again, all on one page. The other tool that you have up here in your workbook's view is the Custom Views. Now, this tool will allow you to set up custom views of various areas within worksheets or entire worksheets, and you can kind of jump between them using the Custom Views. And then finally, the last view tool that you have up here in Workbook Views is the Toggle Full Screen View. When I select this view, notice that my ribbon disappears, my Quick Access Toolbar disappears, as well as my office button, and even my status bar down at the very bottom has disappeared. This allows you to view your work using the full display area of your monitor or your screen display. To get out of this view, simply press the Escape key from your keyboard, and you will go back to having all of your toolbars, ribbons, and office button available to you. Let's go ahead and apply this to our product list. So please go ahead and open up your product list or make it the active worksheet. If you'd like to start with a clean file at this time, you can do that by opening up the 0605 start file, which you'll find in your Chapter 06 directory in your Excel 2007 course folder. I'll go ahead and use this file. Here's our product list up to development right now in this tutorial, and to view the product list, go ahead and click one of the page break preview tools. And notice that my product list is fitting all on one page at this time. And then let's go ahead and try our menu worksheet and see how that looks in the page break preview. So I'll go ahead and select the page break preview tool again. And again, notice that everything is fitting on one page, which is great. Also note that if I go back here to my product list tab and make that the active worksheet, and then come over here to page layout and change my view to page layout, because we have froze our panes, this view is not compatible with that feature.